Hello and welcome to our new animation video on glycolysis, the process of breaking down glucose to produce energy. Glycolysis is a series of chemical reactions that convert glucose, a 6-carbon sugar, into 2 molecules of pyruvate, a 3-carbon compound. Glycolysis also produces 2 molecules of ATP, the energy currency of cell, and 2 molecules of NADH, an electron carrier that can be used for further energy production. Glycolysis is an ancient metabolic pathway that evolved long ago and is found in almost all living organisms. It is the first step of cellular respiration, which is the process of extracting energy from organic molecules. However, glycolysis does not require oxygen and can also occur in anaerobic conditions where oxygen is absent or limited. Glycolysis takes place in cytoplasm of the cell. There are 10 steps of glycolysis. Step 1. Phosphorylation of glucose. In this step, a phosphate group is transferred from ATP to glucose in the cell cytoplasm by the action of enzyme hexokinase. The product of this step is glucose 6-phosphate, which has a phosphate group attached to its 6th carbon atom. In this reaction, one molecule of ATP is consumed and one molecule of ADP is produced. Step 2. Isomerization of glucose 6-phosphate. In this step, glucose 6-phosphate is isomerized into fructose 6-phosphate by the enzyme phosphoglucose isomerase. In this case, moves the carbonyl oxygen from carbon 1 to carbon 2, forming a ketose from aldose sugar. Step 3. Phosphorylation of fructose 6-phosphate. In this step, another molecule of ATP transfers a phosphate group to fructose 6-phosphate and converts it into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate by the action of enzyme phosphofructokinase. The product of this step is fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, which has 2 phosphate groups attached to its 1st and 6th carbon atoms. Step 4. Cleavage of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. In this step, the enzyme aldose splits fructose 1,6-bisphosphate into dihydroxyacetone phosphate or DHAP and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate GAP, which are isomers of each other. DHAP has a double bond between its 2nd and 3rd carbon atoms, which is a ketone group, while GAP has a double bond between its 1st and 2nd carbon atom, which is an aldehyde group. Step 5. Isomerization of dihydroxyacetone phosphate. In this step, the enzyme triose phosphate isomerase converts dihydroxyacetone phosphate into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which is a substrate needed for the next step of glycolysis. Step 6. Oxidative phosphorylation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. In this step, each molecule of GAP undergoes 2 reactions. First, it is dehydrogenated by enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase GAPDH, which transfers one hydrogen molecule to oxidizing agent nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide or NAD+ to form NADH and H+. Second, GAPDH adds phosphate from the cytosol to the oxidized GAP to form 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, which has 2 phosphate groups attached to its 1st and 3rd carbon atoms. Step 7. Transfer of phosphate from 1,3-diphosphoglycerate to ADP. In this step, the enzyme phosphoglycerokinase transfers a phosphate from 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate to a molecule of ADP to form ATP. The product of this step is 3-phosphoglycerate, which has a 1-phosphate group attached to its third carbon atom. Step 8. Isomerization of 3-phosphoglycerate. In this step, the enzyme phosphoglyceromutase relocates the phosphate group from the third carbon atom to the second carbon atom of 3-phosphoglycerate, forming 2-phosphoglycerate. Step 9. Dehydration. In this step, the enzyme enolase removes water molecule from 2-phosphoglycerate, forming a double bond between the second and third carbon atoms. This reaction produces phosphoenol pyruvate, which has a high-energy phosphate bond that can be used to generate ATP in the next step. Step 10. Substrate-level phosphorylation. In this step, the enzyme pyruvate kinase transfers a phosphate from phosphoenol pyruvate to ADP, forming ATP and pyruvate. This pyruvate has 3 carbon atoms and can be further processed depending on the availability of oxygen.